Hey guys, and welcome back to Hoosier Hardware. And today we're gonna be talking about Nvidia's GeForce Now program. Now, for those of you that actually pay attention to game streaming services, GeForce Now has actually been available for some time now, but it's been in kind of this semi-open beta. There was a wait list that you would eventually get an email and you could actually sign up and try it out. And now Nvidia's actually finally launched it to the public. So you can go there now, and I'll leave that link down below in case you're interested, and sign up. And the service is completely free on the basic level, but there are some limitations, like having yourself limited to 1 hour play sessions, which can be a little bit of a buzzkill. So there is a $5 tier that does allow you to use RTX, as well as those sessions are not limited in any way. So that gives you a little bit more than an hour to play. You can just kind of play it however you want. And the best part is, you know, that $5 price tag is not all that bad, especially if you're weighing that against building a gaming PC yourself. This is going to give you instant access to the games that you want to be playing, and $5 a month, you know, we're talking very low cost here to get up and running. And then if you are saving up for a PC, you can actually sort of save money on the side and then eventually build yourself a local machine to run games. But all the while, this lets you get up and running at a very low cost. Now, of course, you are going to need something to actually play the games on, but you can use a Mac, you can use a Windows-based PC, you can use an Nvidia Shield TV, or you can even use an Android phone if you want, which I also assume you could use an Android tablet if you actually had one of those that was capable. But you can use those different devices to use Nvidia GeForce Now. So this actually is a really solid way if you don't even have a computer yet. Maybe you just have an Android phone. You can get up and running. But of course, the biggest struggle for game streaming in general has always been bandwidth issues, as well as latency in general. The fact of the matter is, not everyone has a capable internet connection where you can get up and running on one of these services. So the first and foremost, you're gonna have to have a solid internet connection. And I don't just mean one that has a high download and high upload rating, but also just a consistent one. Otherwise, you're gonna see some drastic fluctuations in the quality of your gameplay. But more specifically today, we're going to be looking at some latency issues, because latency is something that is instantly going to turn a game from enjoyable to completely unplayable, depending on if that latency gets too great. We've all been in an online game and had our ping shoot up to something like 200, 300, or even 400 milliseconds, and at that point the game is just unplayable. Everything is jumping all over the place and it's just not a good experience. So latency is the biggest thing that I want to look at today. I'll let you sort of figure out whether your internet connection is strong enough. Latency, though, that's something that is going to be controlled not just on your side of things, but also on the server side of things. Okay, so here we are in the actual sort of scene that I set up here in Adobe Premiere. And I want to note, on the left side we have the local gameplay. In this case, we're looking at Overwatch. And on the right side here, we have the streamed from Nvidia's GeForce Now service. Now, I left everything as far as my streaming goes at default. So any of the servers that we're connected to were completely based on GeForce Now. I didn't use a VPN or anything to connect through, trying to keep everything as streamlined for my use case. Though, of course, with any sort of streaming service, this has gone wildly varied depending on your internet connection and what servers everything connects to in your case. This was just my case. So if we start scrubbing forward here, we get to this point right about here that I've deemed sort of as the point where the mouse was roughly actuating. Now, this is absolutely not perfect because I don't have any sort of indication light on the mouse itself to tell me exactly when a button was pressed. So I can't exactly tell you that this was absolutely the moment that the switch actuated in both cases. I was basing that purely zoomed in on the mouse button itself. In this case, this is where I deemed that the mouse buttons were stopped moving forward for each case. I was kind of slapping the mouse button with my finger here on the slow-mo. So I did it as fast as possible to make it as much of a hard stop on the mouse button as possible. But there's no perfect way for me to deem this. And then I basically just counted frames, and this was done at 480 FPS at 720p. And at this point here, we can just see the flash in Overwatch on the local machine going off at this sort of TV screen over here on the left side. But that was 18 seconds, which breaks down to 37.5 thousandths of a second. And then we move forward just a little bit further here and we get to 44 frames on. And once again, we can just barely see that flash going off here, at which we are 44 frames beyond the point that I deemed as actuation, which is roughly 91 thousandths of a second. So definitely a little bit slower on the stream side of things, though once again, if you live right next to the data center that one of these servers is housed at, then you may see significantly less latency than people living elsewhere in the country or even elsewhere in the world. Now we have the same sort of setup going on here in Fortnite. Here, left side, we have a local scene, right side, we have the stream, and sort of right in this range is where I deemed that the mouse was actuating for both sides. Once again, definitely some variance there and some margin for error introduced. But if we scroll forward here by about 14 frames, we see on the left side, the local machine going off here at 29 thousandths of a second. And we have to scrub just a little bit further forward at 24 frames, we see that flash going off on the right side on the stream. And once again, this was fairly consistent across my testing in my use case with my connection to the server. But again, this will definitely vary wildly depending on each individual person's use case. I will absolutely say though, there is no way around it. You're still adding some latency here by running a game off of GeForce Now. So that brings us to the conclusion of the video. And I was very surprised that GeForce Now, at least for me connecting to the Midwest servers here, it was actually pretty solid. And that's a real surprise because I fully anticipated going into this video thinking about how am I gonna present this when it's really tough to play a game like Fortnite or Overwatch and actually be competitive whatsoever. Now, Fortnite looks like it's definitely gonna be no problem at all. Like I could have played that and felt good about what was happening because my perception was I was clicking the fire button on my mouse and I was firing and I didn't really see any major issue with what was going on there. Now, Overwatch was definitely a little bit delayed and I don't know that I would want to play that through GeForce Now, at least if the results were staying consistent to what I was seeing when I did the test. Though Fortnite, definitely playable in my instance. And the downside to game streaming really comes down to whether you can connect to a server or not and have a consistent experience. And that so far has plagued every single game streaming service that I've seen. Google Stadia had its major issues at launch. Right now, GeForce Now actually looks fairly solid for at least me. But again, I have a great internet connection. I am located somewhat close physically to a server center for Nvidia. So all these things are playing to my advantage. Though, because this does have a free tier, which was what I was testing on, the nice bit is there's absolutely no downside to signing up for the service and just testing it out yourself. And I think that's something Nvidia did really well here, and that's just giving people a free way to test out the game. Because there are plenty of free-to-play games, Fortnite being one of them, where you can just hop on the system and try it out with no added cost. And if you find that it's unplayable for your internet connection or for your area, or maybe even at just certain times, you can make an informed decision on whether you want to spend the $5 per month to get the premium version of the service. So this is actually where the community can kind of help everyone else out, because I am one person testing out a couple of different games and looking for some latency issues. And you know, I found that there is definitely some added latency, and that's what we will see. But I do want to hear from you guys. Put comments down below if you've tried out this service. What are your anecdotal findings? Maybe you don't have specific numbers to back everything up. Maybe you didn't time everything out or film it side by side like I did in this case. But let us know in those comments down below what you think of GeForce Now in your area. And make sure to put, like, you know, where you live, maybe your internet connection specs, that sort of thing. And of course, if you found this video helpful, give it a like, share, subscribe, comment. All those things are helpful to the channel. You can follow me both on Instagram and on Twitter at Hoosier Hardware. And as always, I'll let YouTube queue up a couple more videos from my channel for you to watch. I'm Shane with Hoosier Hardware, and I'll see you guys in the next video.